A reading from the letter of Paul the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, God, who is rich in mercy, because of his great love he has for us, even when we were dead in our transgressions, brought us to life with Christ. By grace you have been saved. Raise us up with him and seated with him in the heavens in Christ Jesus, that in the ages to come he might show the immeasurable riches of his grace in his kindness to us in Christ Jesus. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not from you, it is the gift of God, it is not from your works, so no one may boast. For we are his handiwork, created in Christ Jesus for the good works that God has prepared in advance, that we should live in them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
St. Paul is trying to really make the people of Ephesus, and also tonight each one of us, to make us understand that God, one of the great qualities he has, is mercy. God loved us so much that he gave us his only son. And he gave him to us even to the wood of the cross. And that was the gift from the Father to us, so that through him we can be reconciled with the Father and begin again our walk towards him. And that's why St. Paul said, when we were in transgressions, when we were enemies to God, when we, with our disobedience of our forefathers, have sinned, even then God finds even mercy towards us. In fact, he loved us more then when we were sinners. And so each one of us has been saved by the action of God made flesh, Jesus Christ. That tomorrow, the 25th of this month, we celebrate the Feast of the Incarnation. When God, in his fullness of time, sent that promise of the Old Testament to the reality in the womb of the Virgin, that by her fiat and by God sanctified that womb, begin the preparation of that Christ who was incarnate in her womb, in preparation for this great mystery that we are about to celebrate in a few weeks, that by his death we have been given the chance to live again, and by his resurrection we have the hope of everlasting life. And that's why today St. Paul reminds us that by the grace of Jesus Christ, that grace that comes to us by the paschal mystery of Jesus, by the dying and rising, by the death that he endured on the cross, and by the promise of the Father to raise him from the dead, that is the grace of salvation. And that grace begins in us when he died. And he wants us to have that grace so that each one of us will one day, after we have been, as we say, reassured of our salvation, one day we will be seated with him. Because if we are now reconciled, and now we become adopted sons and daughters, we have now the pledge that each one of us is an heir of the kingdom. That's why he said at the Last Supper, I don't want your heart to be troubled. Have faith in God. Have faith in me. Because I am going to the Father to prepare a place for you. And then I will come and take you to myself. So where I am, you also may be. And that's why St. Paul said we are at the right hand of the Father. Because where Jesus is, at the right hand of the Father, we one day, if we accept him in our lives, live by his very word, we will be there with him. And that's why he continues to say, we are saved by the grace and the faith in Jesus Christ, not by our any works of ours. Because many people think that because, you know, we go to church and we do all kinds of devotions and all kinds of good things, that we coming to gain heaven. No. Heaven was given to us as a pledge of the dying and rising of Jesus. He paid the price. He paid the price on the cross, and now each one of us is the recipient of that gift. And that's why God gave it to us, so none of us can boast that by our own works we have been saved. But we are the handiwork. We are the precious creation. And as I told you someday, in the creation of Adam, God saw his son. But in time, his son was going to take the flesh of that same person he created in the beginning. And that's why he created Adam in the image of his son, so that he would create us in the image of his very son. And that's why he said he prepared us in advance, so that when Christ came and walked this earth, he was like us in everything, St. Paul said, but said, he really made us understand that by the life that we have in us, by the life of God we have in us, which we call it the conceptive grace, we are in advance prepared so that this grace will lead us to glory. And that's why we say at the beautiful consecration, the Christ who died, the Christ who is risen, which is the seal of our salvation, is the Christ who came in glory. Because his glory is ours too. If he shall with us everything that we have, as we say in the beautiful prayer where we mix the water and the wine, as Christ himself come to share our humanity, may we share his divinity. Yes, because by being sons and daughters, we become sons and daughters of the eternal Father. May each one of us really understand the great privilege we have, that we have been chosen, that by the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus, and by faith in him alone, by the sacrifice that Christ himself really achieved for us on the cross, we all have been saved. So that we now have been saved and reconciled, we continue to live the dying and rising of Jesus in our life, by dying to sin and rise with him to the life of grace. So this life will lead us to the great glory